गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस आफ्टर दिवाली वेकेशन। आई होप यू ऑल हैव एंजॉयड द वेकेशन एट होम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेटर राइटिंग। सो ऑलरेडी आई हैव टॉट how to write informal letter. Before that, let's see the definition of letter. A written, typed or printed communication sent in an envelope by post or messenger is a letter. Already you have learned how to write informal letter, that is letters to friends and family. Today we are going to start with formal letter. So let's see what is formal letter. Formal letters are letters to people who we don't know on a personal level. Means personally we do not know those people. In other words, sorry, there is a spelling mistake here. In other words, formal letters are also known as business letter. For example, we may write to find out information and apply for job, etc. So these are letters written to an organization or institute, or to the principal, class teacher, librarian, to the editor, and so on. Now, why do we write a formal letter? We write a formal letter to provide or ask for information. If you want to give any information or if you want to ask any information, we write formal letter. To make inquiries or respond to the inquiries. Then for registering the complaints, we write formal letters. Suppose you have to complain about the nuisance caused by stray dogs in your locality. You can write in a complaint letter. Or suppose you have purchased anything like washing machine or TV or computer and it is not working properly. So you can make a complaint by writing a complaint letter. Next, you can also write formal letter to place orders and send appropriate reply. Suppose you are a seller and you want to order the things. For example, you want to order some books, then you can write a letter to place order. Or if somebody has placed order with you, you can give the reply in a formal way. Next is to promote or persuade. Then to send recommendation, to make an appeal, or to give a warning. For all these things we write formal letters. Next, let's see the format of a formal letter. See, you have learned the format of informal letter. So there is a little difference in the format of formal letter and informal letter. So let's see how to write a formal letter. What is the format of formal letter? So we are going to see the full block style. Full block style means you have to write everything at the left hand side near the margin. Like you can see the lines, everything at the left hand side. Now first, at the top left, you have to write the sender's address. Sender's address means the person who is sending the letter. Now, if you are sending the letter, you are the sender. So you have to write the sender's address. Then, next is after sender's address, you need to write date. Now, date may be written in two ways. For example, now here it is given 14th May 2016, or else you can also write May 14, 2016. Okay. After date, you have to leave line and write the receiver's address, receiver's designation and address. Now, for example, here the designation you are writing to the editor, so to the editor. If you are writing to the principal of school, you can write to the principal. If you are writing to the class teacher, you can write to the class teacher. You have to write the designation and then the address. After receiver's address, you need to write the salutation, that is respected sir or madam. You can also write dear sir or madam. Then you can also write only sir or madam. Or you can write dear Mr. and name of that person if you know the name. These are the ways to write the salutation. After salutation, you have to write the subject. Now, subject is the short description of the purpose of writing the letter. Why you are writing the letter? So, in short, you have to write the subject. It should be not more than 6 to 7 words. Next, after subject, body of the letter, it is divided in three parts. First is introduction. So in this paragraph, you have to give the introduction, the purpose of writing your letter. Then second, main content, that is you have to give the detailed information about the letter. And next is conclusion. You have to conclude the letter, or you have to write what you expect from the receiver. So that will come in the concluding paragraph, that is last paragraph. After that, you have to leave one line and write thanking you. And next, yours sincerely, faithfully, truly, or you can also write obediently. So yours sincerely, or yours faithfully, or yours truly, or yours obediently. So any of these closing can be written. After that, you have to write the name, that is your name. If the name is given in the question, you have to write that name, or else you can write any name. And if there is any designation, you can also mention the designation. This is the way which you have to write a formal letter. I hope you have understood how to write a formal letter. In our next video, we'll see example of formal letter. Thank you.